Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com, and welcome back to our Raptor 700 build. Today we're going to be focused on putting the head together for our 2017 Raptor 700R. Going to work on lapping in the valves, getting those installed, getting everything, the springs and the keepers and everything put together so we can continue on our engine build. Now, if you need help gathering up the parts for your build, why don't you check the link in the description below, and that'll give you the exact shopping list for this particular engine. Now, if yours is a little bit different, if you would visit our website at Partzilla.com, it's really easy to use. Start off by picking the manufacturer and then drill down to whatever part or list of parts that you need for your machine. If you're still having trouble, then give us a call. That's what we're here for, and we can guide you to the correct parts for your application. So now that you've got your parts together, let's talk about the special tools that we're going to need to pull this off. It's a fairly short list. You are going to need to pick up a good bearing driver set, as well as a valve spring compressor. Other two small items, need to pick up some valve lapping compound, as well as a valve lapping holder, which actually goes to the end of the valve where you can spin it back and forth. So now that you've got your parts together and your special tools, let's go over there and get that thing put together. Let's roll. All right, step number one, even though this is a brand new head, we need to make sure it's clean. So let's get some parts cleaner and spray it off and make sure she's good to go. And I'm gonna go in, make sure the seats are clean, wipe it out as much as possible, because even though mine is brand new, there's still a fair amount of debris left in it from its manufacturing process. And I don't want that flying around the engine when we start it. I mean, Yamaha does a good job getting it cleaned up and sealed up, but that's just one extra step that doesn't take that long. This was a clean rag when I started. We'll concentrate on the other parts later. Right now, I just want to deal with the valves. So let's start off by marking where the valves are going to end up in the head. We're just going to be 1, 2, and this is 1, 2. Let's go ahead and get some blue dye onto the face of the valve so we can see what the contact area is with the head. And we're just going to put a thin layer around the face of the valve right here. So when you're doing this, what you're looking for is a stripe roughly 1/3 the width of the valve, maybe a little bit less. It'll end up being in between 1 and 1.2 millimeters, and I'll show you that later. Before we actually put the valve in there, let's put a little bit of assembly lube just on the stem, because I don't want to score up anything with our brand new parts. Just a few turns back and forth. And it's actually looking pretty good. It's got a little edge on the top and the bottom, and then a nice contact area there in the middle. It looks even all the way around on the valve seat. And honestly, that's what I expected. I mean, it's a brand new factory part from Yamaha. This is the way it's gonna look, this way it's supposed to look. So this actually looks fantastic. It's what I expected, but I'm still gonna lap it in. But what is going to change is which lapping compound that I'm going to use. When you go to pick out your valve lapping compound, typically you can get that at most any auto parts store. You want to take note of the grit or the coarseness of each one, because you can get different values. I happen to have a range from 220 up to 600. For a new build like this, the 600 will do fine. For one that needs a little bit more help, the 320. If it's severely pitted, you can drop it down to the 220. So when you are doing this, make sure that you don't get any of the lapping material on the stem of the valve. It's going to be critical. We don't want any of that to stay in the engine. So we're going to put a very light layer, kind of like we did with the Prussian blue, around the face of the valve. Now here's where you want to listen. It's going to start out with a lot of sand sound to it. And as you go back and forth, that sound's going to decrease. So at that point, you lift up a little bit, let it draw in more of the lapping compound, and then do it again. Now, I'm not pushing hard, just enough for the suction cup to stay on the other valve. One more time. See how much quicker that it did toward the end as far as when it was really making that grinding sound to when it stopped. That tells me that we're pretty much there. All right, pop that out. Get your valve cleaned off. Now you can look on the face of the valve. See that line right there in the middle? That's what we just did by lapping it in. Created that area that perfectly matches what's inside the head. Now that we've got the valve cleaned up, we need to get the head surface cleaned up as well. Looking good. Let's go on to the next one. All right, on to the intake side. So we've got her cleaned up, the valves are lapped. I want to check one more thing, our actual seat width, or that contact point, needs to be in between 1 and 1.2 millimeters, not to exceed 1.6. And let's say we are dead on 1 millimeter, or close to it, or that's the best my eyes can see. Let's start installing the valves. First thing we need to do is go ahead and lay in our valve spring seats. And then we're going to put in the valve seals. Should be able to just push these down with your finger. And you can kind of feel them lock in. They do not go all the way down to the seat itself. So don't be expecting it to go that far. All right, let me go get the valve spring compressor, then we'll start getting those valves in. I find it easier just put it in a clamp, or in this case, the vise, and we're gonna start out with intake number one. We're gonna put a little bit more lube on it. Make sure it goes into intake one that I marked. Now, before I carry it up there, let's go over this real quick. Your valve springs, these are marked with paint that show, you know, which way is up. But if not, see how the spacing changes as it gets to the top? When it's really tightly wound, that's the part that you want going down to the bottom. And then, of course, as it expands or it gets a larger distance, that's what you want facing up. So let's pop that in place. Go ahead and get our collar, then our keepers. Now, the other little trick that I do is I put just a little dab of grease on the keepers. That helps kind of hold it to the stem as I work them into position. That, when I'm bringing them in there, actually sticks to the end of the screwdriver. Makes life a little bit easier. This can be tedious. There's one. Now before you go into the next one, we just want to get a soft mallet, if you will, and just pop it a couple of times to get those keepers to seat in. Don't have to hit it hard, just enough to shake it down. That one looks good to go. Let's go on to the next. I feel like a dentist when I'm doing this. Open wide. So how's the family doing? Good, good. Two down, two to go. So we've got our valves in. Let's start working on the camshaft bearing, the camshaft, and then our rocker arms. All right, with the bearing, we want the sealed side facing toward the camshaft. So we want this part to go in first. Before we pop it in there, let's go ahead and oil the bearings. Looks like there's a fair amount of grease in there, but we're gonna add to it just to make sure. So we've got it down in place, and we're gonna drive this all the way down so there's a zero clearance with the head. So it goes all the way to the bottom. Make sure that you get her in there square. Yeah. she's down. Next, let's go ahead and get our camshaft installed. Go ahead and add a little oil to that decompression mechanism on the inside, as well as that pin out here. Then we can go ahead and put some oil directly into the bearing. Tell you what, while we're here, let's go ahead and put some break-in engine lube on our lobes. All right, now we can go ahead and get our camshaft in. The orientation, you want to lower it down, or with these little two sections kind of facing up. Be careful doing this. Try not to knock your lobes. Next, let's get the intake rocker arm in there. What I'm using is just a fairly long 6mm bolt to thread into it, into the rocker arm shaft. Then we're going to tap it to get it started in there. We're going to stop while there's still enough room to get our rocker arm lined up. Yep, there she is. It's right at the edge. All right, going to put a little bit of assembly lube, spread it around the inside of the rocker. All right, so let's slide our rocker arm in there. Best thing I can tell you to do here is just eyeball it as good as you can and tap gently in case it's not lined up. Got it. That is it. Doing the same thing, just to the other side. Yeah. Now let's get a retaining bracket in. It actually holds in the bearing as well as the rocker arm shafts. The way to do that, bring it in from where the chain, timing chain is going to be located. Lift up on the camshaft just a tick, and then it'll slide in and then rotate around just like that. The real trick is when you're doing that, just to lift up on the camshaft, maybe an eighth of an inch is all it takes. Now, let's get the retention bolts in. Generally speaking, especially if it's on the inside of the engine, I'm going to use a little bit of Loctite. All right, let's go and get them in place. Get those guys torqued down. Anybody want to guess? If you said 7.2, you'd be correct. So she's almost ready to go. The cam is actually sitting in, I think it's going to be the split overlap. I'm going to go ahead and put the adjusters and the pinch bolts on there, but they're going to be completely retracted at the time because I'm not going to actually set the valve lash. I mean, if you've got your head off your machine and you want to go ahead and set it now, yeah, there's nothing wrong with that. But I want to be able to show you how to do it with the engine complete, bringing it around a top dead center. We're also going to be doing a video that specifically addresses setting the valve lash on this engine start to finish. All right, guys, that pretty much wraps this one up. Listen, if you need any parts for your machine, particularly this exact one, there's a link in the description below that will carry you to a shopping cart that has every single part that we use to build this up. If your machine's a little bit different, why don't you check out our website at Partzilla.com. It's a really easy to use menu where you can drill down and get to whatever part that you may need for your machine. And if you're still having a little bit of trouble, give us a call on our 1-800 number. We're here to help you out. Listen, we just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at Partzilla.com. And if you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. Once again, we just want to say thank you and we will see you in the next video. Have a great day.